Sagar, who is a Kannada poet, playwright, translator, teaching creative writing at the Srishti Institute of Art, Design and Technology in Bengaluru. Mamta is a recipient of poetry residency and official projects of the India-Wales season and the UK-India year of culture 2017-2018. Mamta has collaborated her poetry performance with visual artists, musicians and poets from other languages, language cultures within and outside India. Kavya Sanjay, a community poetry event curated by her, connects poetry with people. Next, I'd like to welcome Surekha, who is a visual artist and curator exploring artistic form through installations, video and photography for the last 2 decades. Her work investigates how visuality engages with ecology and socio-political aesthetics, negotiating public and private spaces. She's based in Bangalore and the ever-altering city itself has been the subject of her artistic representation. She's been involved in visual art collectives like BAR1, VAG Forum, Coach, and she was a founder curator of Rangoli Metro Art Center, Bangalore. Deepu co-founded Pedestrian Pictures, a Bangalore-based film collective in 2001. He has directed 8 documentary films and is actively engaged in film screenings and cultural and political activism. He's also a cinematographer with several narrative feature films, ad films, and documentaries to his credit. He worked as a camera person in 41 documentaries. Some of the prominent directors he has worked with are Jim Burrows, Rakesh Sharma, T. Jayashree, and K.P. Sasi. We will also have readings by Shashank, Siddharth, and Vidya. Shashank is a poet, designer from NID. He writes in English and in Hindustani. Siddharth is a Kannada poet. And Vidya is an animation student from Srishti, Bangalore. Over to you, Mamta.
Thank you. Thanks for having us here. It is a tribute to Gauri, but it's not about Gauri. It is about the city and how city gets scripted in various circumstances associated with Gauri, or how Gauri gets scripted in the city, through that how we all of us get scripted, and what happens to the city when it responds to certain things, when it doesn't respond to certain things. And I would now like to invite Deepu to start his presentation. And this is like, you know, we will be, all three of us will be hopping in, hopping out kind of a thing, and lots of visuals.
So what I'm going to show is like, for example, the relationship maybe I share with different part of Karnataka sitting in Bangalore. So there are certain spaces, protest spaces, which exist in Bangalore, where people from across, Karnataka comes and participate. It creates certain kind of relationship, for the, activists, journalists, to etc., who lives in the city. With connects with different parts of Karnataka, different struggles, different issues and other things. So this is a roughly put together 6 minutes of clip which travels through the history from 2002 to now, some of the struggles which happened.
So actually our session, we have understood the visuals as containing of loaded meanings, which also helps us to understand the city and the layers of activity within the city and without.
All right. ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಶಾಂತಿ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಕಾಪಾಡದೇ ಇರುವ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಗುಜರಾತಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಮರು ಅಂಗಡಿಗಳು ಹೋಗಿ
ವಾಸ್ತವವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ.
ವಸತಿ ಕೊಡುವಂತದ್ದು ಅದರ ಆದ್ಯತೆ ಅದರ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ಟಾಸ್ಕ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಘೋಷಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತನಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾಗ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಿದಂಥದ್ದು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಭೂಮಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮನೆ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಘೋಷಣೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ನು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ತೆಗಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇದನ್ನೇ ಆದ್ಯತೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ ಕಂಪನಿಗಳಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಸರ್, ನಾವು ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವೇಗಗತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಸಮಿತಿಯನ್ನು ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಕಂದಾಯ ಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳ ನೇತೃತ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಒಪ್ಪಿದ್ರು. ಸೊ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮೂಲಭೂತವನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟಂತ ವಿಷಯ ಒಪ್ಪಿಕೊಳ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೋರಾಟವನ್ನು ಹಿಂಸೋಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೋರಾಟ ಇತ್ತು.
ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ಸಮಿತಿಗಳನ್ನು ರಚಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ತಿರುಗಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಳ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ನಂಬಿಸಿ ದ್ರೋಹ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಶಾಸನದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತನಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಕ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದು ಬಹಳ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ನೋವಾಗಿದೆ. ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯನವರು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಹೂವಿನ ಹುಚ್ಚ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ.
With these clippings, we also understand that city, Bangalore as a city, a space, you know, which gets projected not just because what it is, it is molded only because there are so many other things that come into the city, and city is responsible, and certain things, if it is a socio, political and cultural layers within the city, addressing those and those who are involved in it, and what makes a city visible, vocal, is something which is very important for us. Now, Deepu, you can.
So, why the last one is an ongoing protest which is still happening, and almost all those issues, actually, when we speak about Gauri also, she was involved with this entire thing. You know, the way whenever I see this kind of town hall is somewhere like, you know, which is something everybody will say that something happens, we will actually go into town hall and do a protest and, you know, hold placards or whatever. But it's not only the people within the city, there are different. For example, recently there is a huge protest happened because some of the manual scavengers, you know, died in BTM layout. So then there is a huge rally which happens. So several times when I look at these faces, what I wonder is that where they came from. You know, I can't really tell that which geographical landscape which these people are come from. They are from different parts of Karnataka. And actually they carry different kind of issues, different even when you look at land struggle itself. For example, in Didahalli, there is a tribal land struggle which happened, where actually a woman, the leader, went naked when the police, destroyed the entire houses. But nobody cared about it, actually, which happened there. Okay, even media didn't carry it properly. But they traveled all the way to Bangalore, and there is a protest, you know, like this, some of these people who's there from there also. Then actually media started, you know, then Chetan went, maybe Gauri went, you know, H.S. Doraiswamy went, then actually people started noticing that there is a struggle which is like this, tribals are demanding for land. So, you know, the city and this, you know, the people who are much more visible within cities, the identities which is, you know, within different spheres, whether it's media, whether it's activism, you know, the more visibility and, you know, of the political issues which actually derives from this city. And even the relationship with the state also, because this is a capital, you know, city. So, you know, almost every time you are continuously in negotiation with the state. And that is, you know, it is not done by the, you know, structure of the system, not by these people who are sitting there, majority of the people who come onto the streets, but in terms of, you know, this kind of identities, like, you know, H.S. Doraiswamy or Gauri Lankesh or somebody else. So, you know, or like me being a filmmaker who actually starts his journey to different villages, also starts from this kind of spaces. And what happens is that there is a relationship start building up. There's actually a construction of a political identity as well as, you know, you being an individual start evolving. That is what, for example, referring to any of the activists, including from 2001 onwards, the Gauri's journey also, you know, it evolved through this, you know, people and images and the incidents which happened outside of Bangalore, even some are in Bangalore also, but in terms of deriving a relationship with those, you know, political scenarios and intervening and you know it's a constant journey of an interesting interaction where you know the political growth of either an individual filmmaker, journalist or anybody in that way, activist, evolves with the interaction with these people who doesn't actually carry such kind of a strong ideological positions which we, you know, give it to them. Maybe when we see a red flag and people behind it, we always call them they are from the left or Marxist. But majority of the masses are not. They are actually demanding land and who's fighting with them is... these identities which is getting constructed within the cities, whether all the political parties, you know, the heads to everybody is situated in this city. So those identities, like any of those individuals, whatever identities constructed by them, which has been assumed to these people who comes onto the street to protest and other things. So, you know, what I'm telling is that is this city, you know, in that way, not only shaped the discourse within the city, but in terms of, because it's a capital city and other things, it's actually quite a big part of the political discourse in and across Karnataka. And it plays a key role. And that's where actually Gauri as an identity also got constructed, her evolution happened as well.
And Deepu, actually, I also want to see all these clippings show that everybody is coming to this city with questions. You know, and they are not, I mean, they very well know, and most of the times they are not getting answers. City is in a way asking questions to itself and within itself through these common people and posing or portraying or highlighting the socio-political issue of the people. And you have, one of the clippings was from Baba Budangiri. You traveled with Gauri to many places and also shot. Would you like to remember or give us a few instances?
This clip is actually not from Baba Budangiri. It's actually related to Baba Budangiri in Bangalore. That was a home minister. So we actually decided without any further notice, we decided to karao him. And Gauri, actually I met Gauri first time in Baba Budangiri. I was filming that time. She came there first time. She filed a special report on it. During that period in time, I met her and a friendship grew on. So, the interesting thing about Gauri, I always try to find the differences between activists, maybe a person like me, with Gauri, you know, because I realized, look, I came to Students Movement at the age of 13. So the ideologies shaped my thoughts so much. Even my human relationship with, for example, a homeless, you say, I relate to them with all this, my construct of how to, you know, putting it in the social systems, they will have to. So it's not clearly an organic relationship which I share, but I see them as a part of this entire political plan of mine or entire thing of the change which I dream about and other things. But Gauri was not like that. What I could see is that Gauri emotionally connected with them.
Yeah, and all this, you know, people coming in, issues coming in, voices coming in, you need to voice for people from different socio-political stance which you take along the issues. And I think Gauri did it. And along with many others in the Kannada cultural scenario, and always her concerns were rooted within the Kannada spaces, Kannada political and cultural spaces. And now I would like Surekha to answer. So now if Gauri can voice all these people, and how did all these people voice Gauri is something which we would like to share with you now.
Actually, we can see the video first. That's on 12th September, when the whole mass, I mean like people from all over India, Bangalore, and also like regional areas came and protested in Bangalore. And they almost like occupied the streets of Bangalore, and also you could see so much of angst and anxiety. So we'll just start with the video. It's about 6 minutes, and then we can continue later. it's almost a continuation of Deepu's.
धड़ा धड़ा इसी गुंडो गुंड ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡಲ್ಲ ಸಾಲಾಗಿ ಏಳು, ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡಲ್ಲ ಸಾಲಾಗಿ ಏಳು. ತೂರಿದ್ದು ಗೌರಿಗೆ ತಾಕಿದ್ದು ನಮ್ಮೆದೆಗೆ.
Yeah, there were people in both the clippings. They looked similar. One was asking for whatever they wanted. I think even here they were doing the same thing and voicing for Gauri, and everybody called themselves as Gauri. That day on the 12th, when we organized Nanu Gauri, you know, I think all of us, even I am Gauri, people came with anger, they came with pain, they came with sorrow, they cried, and the way they responded was, you just can't believe it. I would like Surekha to continue a bit about
Actually, I knew Gauri like since last 20 years, but not like as a friend, like maybe met some 15 to 20 times in many years, like actually. But what happened that particular day was quite amazing, because you can see people from all walks of life and coming there and, you know, using that whole platform, either the street or the dais, like there were intellectuals, culture people, artists, theatre, and the people from all over Karnataka, they were here, and a lot of angst and also the so much of anger. And if you can see some of this youth, you know, like protesters, young people, you can see that, I mean, they're so, like, at the same time fearless, but at the same time there's so much anger actually. So that was like something which I really wanted to kind of capture, and also it was like when you see this sea of people, it is unbelievable, because it's usually, it's always the traffic which takes the street of Bangalore, but here the people took over that particular day. Yeah.
And you know, this initially, as you said, you know, there was this fear which was planted. The whole action was to plant fear in people and make them silent, you know. But this particular thing, this particular day, I think it just broke. None of them who came there or who didn't make it just realized that we are not afraid of anything. Deepu, would you like to say?
Yeah. look, it was, you know, the love of the people, you know, primarily what we could see, you know, they have lost something, because the earlier clips, you know, and this has a relationship because of that, because those people who she spoke for, she actually negotiated for, you know, each and every, you know, last, you know, 15 years, they actually lost something. Okay, that was one major section which has come there. So they were angry. For example, the girls who are actually that playing that drum, they're from a slum struggle in Mandya. Okay, she was a part of it. So, you know, there is this personal loss which was felt. And I think that that kind of a moment, you know, anybody, any person, to, you know, that moment we can challenge anything. You know, we are not really worried about anything. So that actually reflected in that entire thing. And then there is another section who actually she connected in a different way, you know, not the same way with the villages, the city, you know, a particular class which all of us have belonged to. So there are different kind of social relationship which is very personal and political. In, you know, maybe she's a woman, I always, because she's a woman, she could actually relate to people in that particular manner, I felt. And that was, you know, quite reflective in that day's
protest. You know, beyond any class, caste, gender sections, this just happened. You know, it because she also did it beyond everything, you know. She stood for the margins. She just spoke for people who deserved a voice to be projected. And this particular day, when you see the visual itself, will let you know that they were not invited in lorries or trucks. They just came, they poured into the city. The city became completely different. City just, you know, in a way, with all of this around, the city itself was mourning.
No, there is one more thing is that when this protest happened, when this, you know, 12th program happened, as organizers, we didn't had a, you know, idea that how many people really are going to come. So, and because this is not like a protest rally which happens in Bangalore, different places, you know, this, you know, district bring this many people or anything like that. It just, you know, it just happened. People actually came out and, you know, be there on that day. So that was quite... different.
Now I would like to add certain things to what both of you have been talking. Like Gauri as a metaphor has been there all through, and we in the sense city has been connecting beyond city to Gauri or through Gauri or speaking about her and understanding her actions, work, whatever, you know. And with this connection with this metaphor and the city, many things that were hidden in the history or which were masked were unrevealed. So,
you know, if you look in that way, last few years of communal history of Karnataka started discussing or came into the public realm after actually Gauri's
death. Yeah.
Till then, people are not really ready to engage, especially as a city. Bangalore was not ready to engage. You know, it actually, several times engagement becomes merely an expression of a day, just being there in that particular protest spaces, and then, you know, go back where communal, you know, forces in Karnataka were continuously having their journey. Or if you look at the entire question of the idea of the entire Lingayat discussion which has come in, for example, Karnataka, the right-wing's major force is in Lingayat community, and Bilava community's coalition makes them win elections. So that came into discussion also, you know, in a larger manner, you know, in the urban sphere, you know, after Gauri. So
and yeah, I think she also voiced strongly after Kalburgi.
Yeah.
Argued for it, you know, and now with this, I would like to ask, if religion is a conceptual space, if at all we consider it as, and caste is a social space, is there a need to connect caste with the religion? One thing. And then, you know, because a religion in India, whether it is Hinduism or Christianity or Islam, whatever you take, it is not homogeneous. It is multi-layered, and everything happens in every other religion. Then how do you specifically, is there a need to connect caste with the religion is something which I am posing a question. Later on, maybe we can discuss about it. And with that, I would go to the next question. So what happens to women heroes? How are women heroes defined or redefined? And what happens to them if a woman becomes a hero? Does the gender and sexuality, questions around gender and sexuality are addressed or not? To what extent is it addressed? Where is it silenced? Where is it always considered from a patriarchal perspective, unaddressing the sexuality and the gender issues? Would any of you want to say anything about that?
Not particularly about that, but when you think about Lankesh, because in the 70s and 80s and 90s, when Lankesh Patrike came over, he used the same kind of language, and also he was also like very also against all these issues, and also his language also was like really harsh, but the same kind of thing which sort of continued by Gauri, but in a much more different way, in an activist manner actually. But when you think about that, like maybe why it happened to Gauri and not like when you think about the Lankesh, I think maybe it's a time. I think it's a time which sort of more than the just the gender, but I think the last 3-4 years crucial time which we are like at the moment we are facing here. No, I think
And I'm already shown that the time is running out. So I would, Deepu, did you want to say anything?
No, I just wanted to say on the woman heroes. It is quite interesting because I strongly believe that Gauri got killed because she is a woman.
Yeah.
Okay. There is a lot of male activists who is actually, you can see if you look at any of the activists meeting to any of the spaces, you can see it's actually very male dominant. Even the negotiation with the state is also done by a male. Fight against the right wing is done by a male. Okay, so that reflection, what, so right wing doesn't worry about that man fighting, but when a woman occupy that space,
because the definition of a good woman citizen unknowingly comes into this, which we somehow the entire discussion is not incorporating this, and I would like to raise another question about being secular. What is this space of being secular? When you say you are secular, you are already associated with the left wing, you are associated with atheism, you are associated with not doing this, not doing that, stuff like that. Therefore, somewhere there is no space where you can connect with people who don't talk about it. So then, is secular understood, the concept of being secular understood as exclusive? Is it not inclusive? This is one more question I want to raise. And now I request three friends of mine to come and read one of Gauri's article, Then Basava, Now Kalburgi, in English, Tamil and Kannada.
Thank you, ma'am. Namaskar, my name is Shashank, and I'm going to read this article in English. Yesterday, Basavarna, today, Kalburgi. The forgotten egalitarianism of the Lingayat religion. It happened sometime in 2003 or 2004. In a small town called Malebenur, Davangere district, a few Lingayat youths had stripped and raped two women from a minority community to gleeful chants of Jai Shri Ram. Riots and looting had promptly followed. The incident disturbed me extremely since Malebenur is very close to my ancestral village from my maternal side. Malebenur had been a place where Hindus and Muslims had lived in harmony for generations. Soon after the incident, I was invited to talk at a Lingayat Matha in Davanagere. Though I had avoided Lingayat Mathas till then, I decided to go so that I could give a piece of my mind to the local Lingayats. I cited one of Basavanna's famous vachanas, which in A.K. Ramanujan's translation goes, The rich will make temples of Shiva. What shall I, a poor man, do? My legs are pillars, the body the shrine, the head a cupola of gold. Listen, O Lord of the meeting rivers, things standing shall fall, but the moving shall ever stay.
ಉಳ್ಳವರು ಶಿವಾಲಯವ ಮಾಡುವರು, ನಾನೇನು ಮಾಡಲಿ ಬಡವನಯ್ಯ. ನನ್ನ ಕಾಲೆ ಕಂಬ ದೇಹವೇ ದೇಗುಲ ಶಿರವೇವನ್ನ ಕಳಶವಯ್ಯ. ಸ್ಥಾವರ ಕಳಿವುಂಟು ಜಂಗಮ ಕಳಿವಿಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡಲ ಸಂಗಮ ದೇವ ಕೇಳಯ್ಯ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಲಿಂಗಾಯತ ಧರ್ಮದ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕನಾದ ಬಸವಣ್ಣ ಗುಡಿ ಗುಂಡಾರ ಕಟ್ಟುವುದನ್ನು ಸಾರಾಸಗಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ವಿರೋಧಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದ, ಮೂರ್ತಿ ಪೂಜೆಯನ್ನು ಸುತಾರಾಮ್ ಒಪ್ಪುತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಹೀಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಏಕೆ ಕಾಲ್ಪನಿಕ ದೇವನೊಬ್ಬನಿಗೆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ಕಟ್ಟುವುದನ್ನೇ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಉದ್ದೇಶವಾಗಿಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡ ಶಕ್ತಿಗಳ ಜೊತೆ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಎಂದೆ. ನನ್ನ ಮಾತಿನಿಂದ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಗಲಾಟೆ ಶುರುವಾಯಿತು. ನನ್ನ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸಲು ಸಹ ಬಿಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸ್ಥಳೀಯ ಲಿಂಗಾಯತರಿಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಕಡುಕೋಪ ಬಂದಿತ್ತೆಂದರೆ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಪೊಲೀಸರ ರಕ್ಷಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೊರಗೆ ಕರೆತರಲಾಯಿತು.
Fortunately for me, Dr. M.M. Kalburgi also happened to be in Davangere that day and was staying in the same hotel as I. He came to know about what had happened at the Matha and sent for me. That was the only time I ever met him. A gentleman and scholar, he cited various shasanas, inscriptions and vachanas explaining how Lingayats were not Hindus. What you said is correct. Don't be afraid to voice your ideas, he encouraged me.
ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಲ್ಬುರ್ಗಿಯವರ ಬರ್ಬರ ಹತ್ಯೆಯ ಇಂದಿನ ಕಾರಣ ಇನ್ನೂ ದೃಢಪಡಬೇಕಿದೆ. ಆದರೆ ಅವರ ಹತ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು ಬಲಪಂಥೀಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಗಳು ಸಂಭ್ರಮಿಸಿದ್ದನ್ನು ಗಮನಿಸಿದರೆ ಬಹುಸಂಖ್ಯಾವಾದಿ ನಂಬಿಕೆಗಳನ್ನು ವಿರೋಧಿಸುವುದು ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಅಪಾಯಕಾರಿ ಎನ್ನುವುದು ಮನದಟ್ಟಾಯಿತು.
ಅಂಡಯನುಳ್ಳ ಸೆಲರೈ ಪೋಲ ಅಲ್ಲಾಮಲ್ ಪಲ್ವೇರು ವಗೆಯಾನ ಕರುತುಕಳಂ ಇಡಮಳಿಕ್ಕುಂ ನಾಂಗಲ್ ಮಿಗವುಂ ಸಗಿಪ್ಪುತ್ತನ್ಮೈ ಕೊಂಡವರ್ಗಲ್ ಎಂದು ಕನ್ನಡರ್ಗಲ್ ನಂಬುಗಿರೋಂ. துரதிருஷ்டவசமாக 9 நூற்றாண்டுகளுக்கு மேலாக இங்கு நிலைமை மாறவில்லை. கல்புர்கி கொலைக்கு எதிராக ஞாயிற்றுக்கிழமை நடந்த போராட்ட கூட்டத்தில் வைக்கப்பட்டிருந்த பாதகை இதை வெளிப்படுத்தியது. நேற்று பசவன்னர், இன்று கல்புர்கி என்று அதில் எழுதப்பட்டிருந்தது. 12 நூற்றாண்டை சேர்ந்த கவிஞரும் சமூக சீர்திருத்தவாதியுமான பசவன்னர் சாதி அமைப்பு முறைக்கு எதிராக உறுதியுடன் நின்றார். சாதியற்ற சமூகத்திற்காக போராடுவது ஒன்றே கடவுள் வழிபாடு என்று நம்பிய அவர் அதற்காக போராடினார். பிராமண சாதி அமைப்பு முறைக்கு எதிராக அவர் கிளர்ந்த எழுந்தார். கீழான சாதிகளில் பிறந்தவர்களுடன் தன்னை அடையாளப்படுத்தி கொண்டார். மாதர சக்லிய சென்னையாவின் வேலைக்காரருக்கும் கக்கையா என்று தோல் பதனிடும் பெண்ணுக்கும் அவர் பிறந்ததாக சொல்லும் அளவுக்கு சென்றார். அதனை அனைத்து சாதி வகுப்புகளையும் சேர்ந்த மக்கள் ஈர்க்கும் வகையில் பசவன்னருக்கு மற்ற வசனக்காரர்களும் உறுதியான இயக்கத்தை வெற்றிகரமாக கட்டமைத்தனர். தங்களது முந்தைய சாதிய அடையாளங்களை விட்டுவிட்டு அனைவரும் சமம் என்று கருதி புதிய சமூகம் அமைப்புக்குள் வந்தவர்கள் லிங்காய தர்மா என்று அழைக்கப்பட்டனர். எனினும் திருமணம் என்று வரும்போதுதான் பசவன்னருக்கு உண்மையான சோதனை வந்தது.
Two of Basavanna's staunch supporters were Haralaya, a poor cobbler, and Madhuvarasa, a rich Brahmin. Haralaya and Madhuvarasa wanted to show that they really believed in Basavanna's egalitarian society, both in spirit and deed. So it is decided that Haralaya's son, Shilavanta, would marry Madhuvarasa's daughter, Lavanya. Of course, Basavanna gave his blessings to the new couple. A marriage between a Brahmin girl and an untouchable boy was too much for the priestly class to tolerate. They opposed the marriage and complained to Bijala. Bijala, who himself belonged to the Babur community, could not resist the pressure of the upper castes and caved in. Punishment was swift and brutal. The bridegroom Shilavanta's eyes were gouged out, after which he, Haralaya, and Madhuvarasa were tied to the legs of elephants and dragged along the roads of the town till death. Bijala's army also swooped down on Lingayats. Thousands were killed, while many fled in different directions. All they had is evidence for the casteless and caseless society they had tried to establish were the Vachanas composed by various people. In order to protect the Vachanas, the Lingayats placed them in the safekeeping of many people in different places. It was only in the 20th century that they were collected together. Of the lakhs of Vachanas composed 900 years ago, today only about 20,000 remain. As for Basavanna, he was so dismayed at the chaos after the intercaste wedding that he moved away to Kalyana.
Yava Adarsha Siddhantagala Mele Tamma Dharma Sthapaneyagitto aa tattvagalanne indina lingayitaru marethu bittiddare. ಲಿಂಗಾಯತ ತತ್ವಗಳಿಗೆ ವಿರುದ್ಧವಾಗಿ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಮೂರ್ತಿ ಪೂಜೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೇವರಿಕೆ ಹುಟ್ಟಿಸುವಂಥದ್ದು ಎಂದರೆ, ಯಾವ ಪುರೋಹಿತ ಶಾಹಿಯ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ಬಸವಣ್ಣ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಬಲವಾಗಿ ಬಂಡೆದ್ದು ಹೋರಾಡಿದನೋ, ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಲಿಂಗಾಯತರು ಅದೇ ಪುರೋಹಿತ ಶಾಹಿಯ ಸೈದ್ಧಾಂತಿಕ ಗುಲಾಮರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ವಚನ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯ ಹಾಗೂ ಕನ್ನಡ ನಾಡಿನ ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಚರಿತ್ರೆಯನ್ನು ಆಳವಾಗಿ ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಮಾಡಿದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಲಬುರ್ಗಿಯಂತಹ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಈ ಲಿಂಗಾಯತರಿಗೆ ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಧರ್ಮ ಅಲ್ಲ ಎಂದು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಅಂಥ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರನ್ನು ಧರ್ಮನಿಂದಕರೆಂದು ಜರಿದು ಅವರ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಸಂಖ್ಯ ಕೇಸುಗಳನ್ನು ಹಾಕಿ ಕಿರುಕುಳ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ಅವರನ್ನು ಗುಂಡಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಂದ ನಂತರ ಇರಿ ಇರಿ ಹಿಗ್ಗಿ, ನೀವು ಹಿಂದೂ ಧರ್ಮವನ್ನು ಗೇಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ನಾಯಿಯಂತೆ ಸಾಯುತ್ತೀರಿ ಎಂದು ಎಚ್ಚರಿಸಿದರು. ಅವರು ಮರೆತಿರುವುದೇನೆಂದರೆ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಲಬುರ್ಗಿಯವರಂತೆಯೇ ಶತಮಾನಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ ಬಸವಣ್ಣನೂ ಸಹ ಪ್ರತಿರೋಧಗಳ ನಡುವೆಯೇ ತನ್ನ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯಗಳನ್ನು ಗಟ್ಟಿದನಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳದೇ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದರೆ ಇಂದು ಲಿಂಗಾಯಿತರೇ ಇರುತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ.
ನೋ ಒನ್ ನೋಸ್ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಗೇನ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲಿ ಬೈ ಕಲಬುರ್ಗಿಸ್ ಡೆತ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ವಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಯಾಷಿಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೇನ್ ಐಡಿಯೋಲಾಜಿಕಲಿ ವೆನ್ ರಿಫಾರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಯ್ಸಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಬಸವಣ್ಣಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಲಬುರ್ಗಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬ್ರೂಟಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೇಟಲಿ ಶಟ್ ಡೌನ್. ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಹವೆವರ್ ನೆವರ್ ಡೈ. 31st August 2015, Bangalore Mirror.
Thank you. And things haven't changed much, as we know. And all these protests all through are for a change, which for changes, many changes, for which we have been asking. We would like to end this session with a poem written by me, sung by Vasu Dikshit and Bindu Malini. Can we play that, please?
ಗುಂಡು ಧಡ ಧಡ ಎಸಿ ಗುಂಡು, ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡಲ್ಲ ಸಾಲಾಗಿ ಏಳು, ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡಲ್ಲ ಸಾಲಾಗಿ ಏಳು. ತೂರಿದ್ದು ಗೌರಿಗೆ ತಾಕಿತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮೆದೆಗೆ, ತೂರಿದ್ದು ಗೌರಿಗೆ ತಾಕಿತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮೆದೆಗೆ. ಧಡ ಧಡ ಎಸಿ ಗುಂಡು, ಧಡ ಧಡ ಎಸಿ ಗುಂಡು. ಹರಿವ ರಕ್ತದ ಕೊಡಿ ನಿಲ್ಲಲೊಲ್ಲದು ನೋಡಿ, ಹರಿವ ರಕ್ತದ ಕೊಡಿ ನಿಲ್ಲಲೊಲ್ಲದು ನೋಡಿ. ಹೆಪ್ಪುಗಟ್ಟಿದ ನೋವು ನೀಗಲೊಲ್ಲದು ನೋಡಿ, ಹೆಪ್ಪುಗಟ್ಟಿದ ನೋವು ಮೀಗಲೊಲ್ಲದು ನೋಡಿ. ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಯಾಕಾಯ್ತು ಹೇಗಾಯ್ತು ಕೇಳದಿರಿ, ಉಸಿರು ನಿಲ್ಲುವ ಮುನ್ನ ಮಾತಾಡಿರಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿರಿ. ಧಡ 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 ಧಡ.
ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಬಿತ್ತಲು ಬಂದ ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನೂ ಕೊಲ್ಲುವರು, ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಬಿತ್ತಲು ಬಂದ ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನೂ ಕೊಲ್ಲುವರು,
ದ್ವೇಷ ಬಿತ್ತಲು ಇವರು ಬಂದ
ಯಾರಿವರು ಯಾರಿವರು ನಾವಲ್ಲ ನೀವಲ್ಲ ಸಾಕಿನ್ನು ಸಾಕಿನ್ನು ಸತ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಗುರಿಯಿಟ್ಟ ಈ ಸಾವಿನಾಟ ಸತ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಗುರಿಯಿಟ್ಟ ಈ ಸಾವಿನಾಟ ಧಡ 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 ಎಸಿ ಗುಂಡು ಧಡ ಧಡ ಎಸಿ ಗುಂಡು ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡಲ್ಲ ಸಾಲಾಗಿ ಹೇಳು ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡಲ್ಲ ಸಾಲಾಗಿ ಹೇಳು
ಸಪ್ತ ಸ್ವರಗಳ ಹಾಗೆ ಎದೆ ಸೀಳಿ ನೋವ ಹೊತ್ತು ಸಪ್ತ ಸ್ವರಗಳ ಹಾಗೆ ಎದೆ ಸೀಳಿ ನೋವ ಹೊತ್ತು ಹಾಡಾಯ್ತು ಈ ಹೊತ್ತು
ಎದೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ತನ್ನಿ ಬನ್ನಿ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ತನ್ನಿ ಬನ್ನಿ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ತನ್ನಿ
so much unsaid because we had decided to bring in various things. There is no time. If there is a little bit of time, if we can take any questions, I would like my panelists to come here. Otherwise, I thank all my panelists, the readers, and thank you, Rekha and IIHS for having us here. Do we have some time? Maybe 5 minutes. Any questions? And as we said, this session was not about Gauri, this was about us. Gauri as a metaphor. We have been looking at this.
How do you see in the next few months are quite vital because of the elections? How do you see the city navigating itself?
Look, the last year or so, you know, there are several incidents which happened within the city have certain impact. One of the incidents is Gauri's, you know. So, what happened, this particular incident is that there is a certain middle class who is actually not openly taking position, which actually took position on that day. And that's actually a shift in the voting pattern also, which is going to happen within the city. So right now, I'll say that even if some of the areas, even extremely Brahminical areas of Bangalore, even it exists, it supported the RSS and the right wing from 80s onwards, you know, in that spaces also, there is going to be a slight change, but it's not going to make much of a difference in the, you know, the victories and like how many seats Congress won or how many seats BJP won within the city.
Another thing I want to ask is, in Delhi, for example, now on the protest areas, you can no more protest. They've given other spaces where you're supposed to pay $20,000 to protest. And you know, the central areas where you have people flocking all over the city become like the epicenter or become the rupture in the city, is now slowly being like,
You know, it's entire transformation happened in post-90s, and it's not only the question of protest spaces, it's a question of how a citizen of the country have been actually, you know, thrown far away from the state, where reliance and others entered into that space, you know,
And so, you know, in Bangalore also it's the same history, you know. We were actually used to protest in front of Vidhan Sauda. And but when actually Miss World contest started, it happened inside Vidhan Sauda and we have been thrown out 3 kilometers away. That is the first time. Okay, so who entered, who has been thrown out? You'll have to see it like that. Then we were near Mahatma Gandhi statue. We have thrown out. Now actually we have given a secluded space telling that, look, you know, this is actually interestingly not in India alone. There is a G8 conference, when it happened in Canada, there is a police document which came out which told, which categorized good protesters and bad protesters. Good protesters are those where government will tell that you sit in this room and protest, or a space, you know, where nobody have any visibility or anything like that will protest. Okay, so this is protesters. But there are actually, let us look at the political parties when they do it in a city. City get entirely blocked. There is no question of dialogue of, you know, inconvenience to the people, traffic, nothing happens. It happens only these kind of critical questions asked to the state and against the right wing. Then actually you became troublemakers, you became roadblocking, you know, senseless citizens. So you will have to be thrown out without creating any problem within the city. So it's just part of this, ideology which is growing. So we are going to be thrown out much more further. You know, the protest spaces and the protesters.
Thank you. That was a really fantastic panel. I just wanted to ask that somebody coming from Delhi and, you know, coming out very strongly in your panel and in Gauri's life, reading, you know, subsequently, is her location in Kannada, you know, and in. So these other deaths, Kulbarghi and others, I mean, they just seem to leave no mark in the water as in terms of, so many months down the line from this death. Do you think that, you know, the way things are, because by all accounts, you know, the groups are known and there's a certain, so I guess my question, awkward as it is that what is the kind of impact at a Karnataka level of this happening? Now, some months later. Is it just...
Yeah, so my question is different from her and his. So it's more about getting away from political or communal side. So let's say we know we don't support Chinese brands, then also we use Chinese brands. So if we know something is existing in the society, some bad elements or some corrupt elements or some communal elements, how do you go and make people understand, not talking in terms of communal or what has happened in the city in the past, in recent months, recent times or years, so that they understand your word and go on right path, let's say adopting new ways of art, culture, a sense of joy and respecting each other's and forgetting the things, like we don't think about Chinese products and use. So that was my question. How do you make people understand?
Respond, connect both. Respond to yours first. See, when Dabolkar, Pansari and then Kalburgi was shot, Gauri comes in the next line. But how was she different from the other three, you know? Particularly in Karnataka from Kalburgi, she is very different because she openly spoke. You know, first of all, even men could not do that. This is, I'm specifically mentioning this statement. When men could not do that, she did it. As if men can do everything. They don't do anything, okay? But still, you know, she openly stood, she voiced really loud, you know, she called people by names, you know, she, her journalism was activism, she was not a journalist, she was an English journalist, she wrote in English, then she was a journalist, when she had to take up Lankesh Patrike, it becomes Gaurish Lankesh Patrike, and she did not write the way Lankesh wrote. See, her concerns was so rooted in issues and politics, and whether it is Naxalism, whether it is transgender groups, you know, on that particular day, the transgender groups collected so much money and donated for Gauri's thing. And people, you know, people on the streets, they brought water, people brought food on the 12th. Everything was taken care without saying anything, you know. It was done. So, shutting Gauri was very important at this point of time. When somebody speaks aloud, talks about something which is which you see, you feel, but are unable to say anything, you know. So that courage which she showed. And by killing Gauri, it was also a kind of a lesson which somebody is teaching someone else. You know, we need to remember that Kalburgi was a scholar. Kalburgi was also not in Bangalore. He was in Dharwad. Even then, he is an important scholar, cultural historian in Kannada. He is a very important thing. But Gauri was not a scholar. But Gauri was an activist. Gauri was not just not an activist. She was voicing all kinds of marginalization. Not one. She was talking about caste. She was talking, questioning the communal elements. You know, then the whole notion of looking at Gauri becomes different. And so all kinds of hate mail she would get. You know, right from teaching a lesson to a woman, you know what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, blah, blah, blah. Right from that which didn't care, she didn't care, she did, it didn't matter. Then for a person who gets involved in helping the Naxals, calling her a Naxal. And all kinds of tricks were tried, nothing worked with her. She stood there right, you know, very strong. And it was very important to, close that voice, to teach people, you know. And now, for whatever you asked, you know, maybe for this, I think they have something to say. Yes, that is true. And I understand that was a fantastic example you gave, which is so simple and which says so many things. I think, you know, now elections are arriving. There are lots of groups, activists and supporters and people, let us not call everyone as activists, a group of people who are trying to reach, that's why I raised that issue of being secular, you know. I mean, just not calling yourself as anything, reaching people and sharing, for example, you know, try to talk about constitution in a simple sentences to a village person. Inform what are the rights and also talk about day-to-day possibilities and encourage them, tell them that they need not fear. There has to be a strong support. A support system is being built. Then those people who use the Chinese and also crib about it will realize why they shouldn't. Or if they use, you will know that they are using. Now we can't see who is using, who is talking against it. It's all hushed up. You know, that is important for us.
So I just put together, you know, I'll say that one thing is very important. The way we see, you know, three people kill Gauri or like four people kill Gauri, tomorrow they are caught. At the end of it, it's not going to reach whoever planned it or, you know, it just becomes three individuals. But all of us know, you know, which space, you know, who did it in that manner without speaking it out. So the question for several of us is right now to continue this in much more, you know, this fight and continue it much more aggressively. And somewhere it is a, you know, fight against the right wing at large. And these reactions happen like what I have witnessed, you know, I've been part of several of these coalitions to, you know, being a filmmaker, watching it. After so many years, actually after 18 years, almost all the progressive forces in Karnataka came together first time before the election, this time. Okay, that happened because of Gauri's death. So, you know, there is actually much more this kind of formations are happening. Okay, after, this is actually the result of, you know, what happened to Gauri. And it should not have happened, you know, with what happened to Kalburgi, because Kalburgi doesn't have that kind of a relationship. Because she's a person who brought from the Dalit movements to, you know, different left movements to a single table. Because, you know, if three left people are there in a room, then they can't even sit together with each other. But that happened. So that is something which is happening, which will give a hope in terms of taking the, you know, Gauri's legacy ahead. And we want to bring out the newspaper also. We don't want to stop it. So right now, like, we have formed a trust and we are actually
next month we are planning actually to bring out the newspaper, and the work is happening behind it. Because there is a particular tradition which, you know, Gauri's newspaper was a weekly threat to the right wing. So, you know, we can't stop it. Now there is a vacuum of such kind of a newspaper. So we are actually planning to take that ahead. How much of a far we can take it ahead, it might not be a replacement for Gauri, but in terms of whatever she is doing, that has to continue. And there is a, you know, confidence in all of us that we will take it forward.
And one nice thing that happened to Karnataka is, you know, always if there was a Dalit issue, only the Dalits would talk about it. If it was women are expected to just go around and do, and even the diversity within the women movement is not yet realized. But you know, now people have realized that there is something, it might happen to you tomorrow. So the groups, you know, who have got used to being marginalized, they are holding hands. That is something which is positive that is happening in Karnataka. And I think Anil is quiet. He was also part of the whole thing. Would you like to say a few words?
Mamta, we're really running short of time because the next session starts at 2. I'm sorry, but we can catch up. Anybody who wants to chat with you, feel free. I'm really sorry. Yeah, thank you so much for putting this together, Mamta. And thank you so much, Surekha and Deepu, for being part of the session. We'll take a short break now, and we'll be back at 2 sharp for the next session.